Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. Our next guest became a household name on the long-running soap opera All My Children, which was the bomb.
Yes.
I watched it.
So
now
nice.
Seasoned and savvy, he stars as Remy in the critically acclaimed drama Queen Sugar on Oprah's own network. Let's take a look.
Are we going fishing or are you preparing for the apocalypse?
Yeah.
I ain't putting that on.
Look, if we're going to do this, we're going to do this right.
Listen, my daddy was showed with a bucket and a rod. He didn't need all of this.
He had his ways and I got mine. Oh.
Mm-hmm. Please welcome 3-time Emmy-nominated Dondre T. Whitfield.
Yay!
Hey. Hi, Dondre! Looking good!
Yes.
Hey, now!
Yeah.
Hi! What's going on?
Hello!
Told you smell good. Smell good.
Let me get
your...
Okay,
good.
Got you. Okay,
are we good?
Sure.
We good?
He got all it
right.
all going
all
on.
Right.
All going
all right.
on.
All
yes,
right.
he does.
Yes. How are you, sir?
I am great.
Good, good.
I am great. Life is great.
Now, I heard you mean on the greens.
I stay that way.
Yes.
You
okay.
know, you gotta... You know, it's interesting because I grew up in Brooklyn, so there were no golf courses
yes.
anywhere mm-hmm. near where I grew up.
Uh-huh.
But I always say it's very, it's so necessary for us to be able to give our kids
mm-hmm.
The gift of access.
Yes.
You know, we're able to do That's so good. Much if we were able to have the opportunity to be able to do that.
Yes.
Right.
You know, when Venus and Serena's father put tennis rackets in their hands.
Yes.
Look what happened.
Look what happened.
So,
they changed the world of tennis.
Yes,
without
they
a
did.
Doubt.
Yes.
And we need to stop putting limits on what we tell our kids that they're capable of doing.
Right. Mm-hmm.
You know, you could be a scuba diver instructor.
Yes.
Yeah.
You know, so don't put any limits on anything. Allow them to be able to taste life, to see what they like and don't like.
Mm-hmm.
That's how you find your passion.
Absolutely. Mm. Absolutely.
And speaking of limitations, New York City is not short of limits.
Yes.
Right.
Talk to us about how living in New York and growing up in Brooklyn inspired you to be an actor.
Mm.
Wow. Well, when you fight every day and when you're getting your teeth kicked in every day, that will inspire you to do a whole bunch.
So, a lot. Okay.
So,
I can answer that.
So in the neighborhood that I grew up in, there was a teacher who was in charge of doing the school plays.
Mm-hmm.
And she always wanted to engage me, and she said, you need to come and be in my play.
That's awesome.
And I wanted no part of it because being in the school play was the equivalent of being like in the glee club.
Uh-huh.
And I was like, you trying to get me beat up. I'm like, I'm not doing that.
Right.
And one day I got in trouble and she said, look, you either go ahead and serve that detention or come be in my play. And I was like, well, I ain't no dummy. I'm gonna
go
do this
to
play.
The play.
Right.
Yeah.
And then once I got out on stage, all the things that worked against me in class were the things that worked for me
yes.
on stage.
Mm.
So I was like, oh. And then the next day she came in with a list of salaries that actors made. And I was like, wait a minute, people are making money doing
this? Yeah.
Hmm. All right,
yeah.
here it is.
Yeah.
So yeah,
and
so
the
now
rest is history.
That's right.
Yeah.
So I found my passion that gives me a platform to suit my purpose.
Ooh, message.
You found your passion to suit your platform to serve
suit
your
my
purpose.
That's right.
And you are a working actor.
Yes.
And you're booked and busy.
Mm-hmm.
And as a black man, you know, we know that a lot of roles are there's a lot of limitations when it comes
yes.
to that. How are you able to continue to stay booked and busy, obviously because you have purpose.
Yeah.
Definitely because I have purpose. And what I've known, first of all, as an actor, and I tell this to folks who come and ask me all the time, what should I do as an actor? So get trained, because
yep.
that's prepared.
Yes.
So many of us, because the danger of social media is you get a chance to see the final product.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You never get a chance to see what goes into making the final product.
Right.
So everyone thinks that the starting point is the final product.
Right.
That's not it. So we think that I'll do the work when I get the opportunity. Once you do the work, the opportunity will call itself to
yes.
you.
Yes.
Right? So that's really what it is. It's sort of like giving God the indication that you're ready for the blessing that He wants to give you
right.
by doing the preparation work. So we look at God like this ultimate, huge, untouchable being, when really He's just the ultimate father.
Mm.
I have two kids, right? So if my child wanted to have a car and I was gonna gift my child a car, the only way that I would gift them a car is if one of my kids showed me that they were prepared
yes.
to have the car.
Right,
right.
right?
So I can bless you with the car, but I would be cursing you with it if you weren't
Hooray.
Prepared for it.
You know what?
Yes.
He's preaching on today. When we come back, we're going to have more with Dondre Whitfield.
Man, I already loved it, but now it's just over there.
And it's something about a man that speak like that.
Right.
It just changed everything.
Right.
It just changed the perspective of everybody in here.
And we are back on Sister Circle Live with one of the stars of Queen Sugar, Dondre T. Whitfield.
Yes, and he is just pleasant.
Yes, he is.
To be. And smart, man. Which is fun.
Yes.
Speaking of which, your smart, beautiful, fun wife.
Yes.
Sally Richardson Whitfield.
Whitfield. Uh-huh.
Okay, then, because we got to put the Whitfield down to the name. She's a director as well as an actress, and you also direct and act. How do you guys find time for each other plus children?
Well, you know, it's interesting because, you know, she directs lives on the screen. I direct lives off the screen.
Mm.
And our time for each other is, and I said this years ago, I said, babe, we got to work just as hard at our marriage as we do our careers.
Yes.
Because the thing that grows is the thing that you water.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't water it and you put that into a drought, it will die.
Yes.
So you can effectively kill whatever you want to kill, just stop watering it.
Mm-hmm.
So we consciously water our relationship every day.
Wow.
It saddens me because we have friends that we've known for years, and they're just that are falling by the wayside, and literally by the minute, and that literally comes out of a space of not properly watering it, which is the communication, the love, the care. I still date my wife.
Yes.
I call my wife my girlfriend still.
Yes. So, I know it.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
I do all that.
Yes. Mine is my boyfriend.
I love him.
Yes.
Right. Okay. Really quickly, let's talk about Queen Sugar. I mean, you guys address a lot of things from race relations, police brutality. Why is it so important to capture these particular storylines in the show?
Well, you know, it's really important for us as scripted television to be able to tell the stories that are really happening to us off the screen.
Yes.
Because what it does is it gives our community the space to say, you're being heard, and these are actually some of the effective ways that we can actually control our narratives off the screen.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So we actually on the screen give cues to our folks as to what maybe we should do off the screen.
Yes. And Remy is getting to some little love triangles or something going on. Look,
it's getting a little messy. It's getting a little messy.
Yes.
I didn't have nothing to do with that.
Okay.
It is,
I act that. I don't write that.
All right. I love that.
Mm-hmm. Well, Dondre, we're having so much fun with you. Dondre will be on Queen Sugar on Wednesdays at 10 p.m. Eastern on OWN. That's where you can catch him.
That's right. And the conversations. That's right. Always continues at SisterCircleTV.com.
Yes.
Dondre Whitfield, everybody. Mm-hmm.